गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वन मोर अनदर टॉपिक दैट इज़ द वॉल्केनोज इन द लेसन नंबर 3. ऑलरेडी वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ टेक्टोनिक प्लेट्स. इट मीन्स द फोर्सेज, इंटरनल फोर्सेज, एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेज एंड इट्स रिजल्ट ऑन द अर्थ सर्फेस. सो वॉल्केनोज इज ऑल्सो द रिजल्टिंग ऑफ द टेक्टोनिक प्लेट्स. इन द प्रीवियस टॉपिक वी ऑलरेडी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इट. Now, student, if you talk about the volcano, so what is the meaning of the volcano? So it means when there is a sudden eruption of any hot lava with the ashes and the gases, when it is coming from the earth crust, so it is known as the volcano. So student, when it is coming from the earth crust, so that time it is extremely hot, and along with the hotness, it is a viscous. It means it has a stickiness, molten rock materials called magma, charged with the gas and the volatile matter erupt. So when magma is coming outside, that time it is having the temperature 1000 degree centigrade, and it is coming from the magma chambers. In the previous topic, we have learned about what is the different kinds of layer inside the earth, and there we have discussed about what are different matters and the materials is finding inside the different chambers inside the earth. So that's why it is a result of the different kinds of the temperature, heat and the pressure inside the earth and in the form of the volcanoes. Okay, so we can understand when different kinds of the activities is taking place inside the earth. So the pressure, heat and the temperature is only giving the one kind of activity. This is known as the volcano. Okay, so volcano, we can understand here, student. Downside, it is the diagram of volcano is showing to you. You can understand from here. So magma chamber is there. Just we have talked about the earth is consists of different kinds of the things which is inside, and when there is a different kinds of activities taking place. So student, when it is taking place inside the earth and when it is coming outside, so different kinds of the structure we can understand along with volcano. So here we can understand this is the volcano neck, from where the volcano, it means the lava is coming outside. There are the different kinds of lava layers. We can understand this is brown part, this is lava layers and ashes and the cinders. Upside we can see vent. So what is the vent? Vent means when the opening crust of the earth, it means when the earth surface is opening from where the lava with the ashes and the gases is coming out in the form of lava, the magma, and that is known as the volcano. So the opening part is known as the vent. And when is the some other portions which is from where the lava is spreading on the earth surface, this is known as the crater. So this is the some points about volcano we can understand here. Now when the volcano is coming outside, it is forming different kinds of the structures, something which is laying along with the surface. Some is remaining upside and some is going very far from where it is rising up. So on behalf of this one, it is having the different kinds of the erupting portions. Now student, when the lava is coming from the volcano, it is depending on its speed. Okay, it means how slowly the volcano has slowly and explosively depending on the kind of eruption. Okay, so volcanic materials which is coming from the volcano, it is depending on the speed of the eruption. So in this way, it is having different kinds of the structure which we have talked already in the diagram of volcano. Like this way, we are having the example of different kinds of the volcanoes. Now further, we will study about this one. Along these examples, we can understand here when the volcanoes are repeating volcano eruptions result in the formation of a volcanic cone of volcanic mountain, like mountain Fuji in Japan. Okay, it means Japan, in the Japan there is a Fuji, one kinds of the volcano. Okay, Mount Fuji. Mount Fuji, earlier it was like a volcano only. It means it was the volcano, but afterwards it has been converted into the one kind of the mountain. Okay, so that was a result of one kind of activity of the volcano. It means when the volcanic eruption were repeating again and again. Afterwards, large and heavier materials are deposits nearer to the cone like Mount Vesuvius in the Italy. So Mount Vesuvius also one of the example that is located in the Italy. So there is the deposition of large and heavier materials. Another one also strand we can understand here, some volcanoes get plugged or magma forces itself through a narrow vent when lava solidifies in the cone. On erupting again, they are very violent. Imagine how this would affect the people living around such a volcano. So this is very dangerous. Okay, it can give the harmness to the people, those who are living very near to the volcanic areas. In this way, we can understand the erupted lava is more fluid, is spread over large area and can build vast sheet of a lava plateau or the plain. Northwest Deccan Plateau in India, okay, Kimberley in South Africa, West Australian Plateau and Iceland are such formations. So these are the different examples of depending on how the lava is erupting and till which place it is spreading, like a lava or plateau or the plains. Okay, we can understand Deccan Plateau in a country that is spreading on the north and west areas. So this is depending on how the volcano is erupting. So student, we can understand which is our Deccan Plateau in India. Okay, like Maharashtra, Gujarat and some portion of the Karnataka, then Chhattisgarh, like this area. This is a plateau area. So this is mostly the area is formed by the volcanoes. Nowadays we are not having the active volcano, only one kind of volcano in our island in the India. But maybe the million of years ago, this part was also the one of the part of the Pangaea. We have talked already in the last chapter. Okay, so in this way, we can understand. Now, one other thing we can understand here, this picture, this is the Pacific Ring of Fire. This is Pacific Ring of Fire. Pacific Ring of Fire is including the area from Asia to both sides of here, the Northern America and here the Southern America. It means between the Northern America and North America and the South America, and between this Australia and this portion of the Asia. So there is the one kind of the ring. This is known as the Pacific Ring. Why it is known as the Pacific Ring? Because here is the Pacific Ocean. Okay, this area is the Pacific Ocean. So student, you know why we are calling it the Pacific Ring of Fire? Because at least the area is moving 40,000 kilometers along with the Pacific Ocean and the other continent. Okay, and it is considered that the ring is having the 452 volcanoes, and out of 452, 75 are active volcano. So in this way we can understand the Pacific Ring of Fire, it is the source of mostly area of volcanoes and earthquakes. That's why student, if you will understood all the things, so this area is covering by the most of the volcanoes and earthquake. Japan is also locating here only, Pacific Ring of Fire. So Pacific Ring of Fire we can understand from the Asia and Australia and North America and the South America, along with the Pacific Ocean, there is the Pacific Ring of Fire which is covering at least 75% of the active volcanoes. Okay, so this figure is like this way. Now, if you talk about volcano, so volcano already we have talked about here, we have learnt about the volcano, eruption in the crust of the planetary mass objects such as the earth that allows hot lava, volcanic ash and the gases to escape from a magma chamber below the earth surface. Below the earth surface, so this we have already talked here. Now the different kinds of the structure of the volcano, you can understand here how the volcano is erupting and the lava and the ashes, how it is coming from the earth. And depending, just now only I have given some examples of like the Fuji mountain in Japan, Vesuvius in the Italy, they are the example of different kinds of the volcanoes. Here also these are the all active volcanoes. Okay, these are the active volcanoes and these are the some kinds of the dormant volcanoes. Now you will study about the different kind. Now again the structure of the volcano we can understand. Here is the magma chamber. Okay, this is the main, this is the main vent from where the volcano is erupting. Then this portion is the lava crater, already we have talked about. Okay, from the vent it is coming outside. Till here also you can say the vent, before that also I have explained to you. Secondary cone from where, and this is also explained to you the same thing. Okay, the magma chamber from where the lava is coming outside, and the different the crater, and these are the different portions of the volcanoes. So what it is explaining to here, there are probably millions of volcanoes that have been active during the whole lifespan of the earth. During the past 10,000 years, there are about 1,500 volcanoes on the land that are known to have been the active, while even larger number of submarine volcanoes is unknown. Okay, so these are the example of given here, some of the volcanoes. Now if you talk about the volcanoes, so there are different kinds of volcanoes. Okay, volcanoes are different kinds. Some are active volcano, some are dormant volcano, and some are extinct volcano. Active volcanoes, it means which are most of the time they are active. Okay, and this time supposed to be at least 50 active volcanoes on the earth surface, and just I have explained to you 75 the volcanoes are locating along the Pacific Ring of Fire. So the example of there are many active volcanoes. If you talk about, so Varan Island in India, we are having the, and Stromboli and Mount Etna in Italy. So they are the active volcano. If you talk about the dormant volcanoes, so they are called the sleeping volcanoes, have not erupted for a long time. It means if maybe the many years of ago they have erupted, this is not a, any, they, we just got a, some sign of their eruption. But afterwards, they are just very quiet. So the example is the Mount Vesuvius in Italy and Mount Kea in Hawaii. Another one also, the Yellowstone volcano in USA. That is the dormant. Extinct means which volcano never had been erupted in the past. Some example of the, this one, the Zuidwal volcano in the Netherlands, Kilimanjaro in Tanzania, Kenya in Africa. So these are the different kinds of the example of extinct volcanoes. So friend, in this way we are having the three kinds of the volcanoes, that is the active, dormant and the extinct volcano. So there are the different examples of the area where the volcanoes can erupt for a longer time, for a shorter time, or maybe some before many years they were active and afterwards they slept and they became the dormant, or some of the volcanoes maybe there is no any evidence for their existence. Okay, as is, so in this way we can understand. So student, today I am just giving you the one long answer. This you have to be write in your notebook today along with the answer. You have to draw the diagram of volcano. This is the only diagram. This is explaining you the three kinds of the volcanoes, like active volcano, dormant volcano, extinct volcano. Okay, so I hope so whatever today I have been explained to you about the volcano, you will go through, understood it very nicely. will try to understand it very nicely. Then we will take the further topic for next day. Till this much, okay. Bye and thank you.